It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Definitely, you're still watching Game On. We are certainly big on sports. Listen up, guys. Want to take those calls right now. The phone lines are open and 0143378722. That is the number you can call right now and give us those reactions. Give us your comments as well in case you've got any questions for Jaime. You want to take it? Hello, Game On. Good afternoon. Hello. 0143378722. That is the number. Keep those calls coming through. I want to take any questions you might have, any reactions as well you might have. Alternatively, head down to social media. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm doing very fine. What's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Guyana.
What's your name?
I'm called Godfrey.
Yes, Godfrey. Yes, Godfrey. Go ahead with your comment or reaction.
Now, my comment is that Busoga United is not a kingdom name, according to my opinion. Yeah? If you say Busoga United, how is it connected to the kingdom? It's a mere name. So I think they should not start politicking around to disorganize the train, to disorganize the team because of the name.
Okay.
That is my opinion.
Okay, I'll definitely get a bit of reaction there. 0143378722. The question of Busoga United. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello.
Yes, good afternoon. We can hear you. What's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Duda.
Who is this?
This is your correction from Duda.
All right, quickly go ahead with your question or reaction.
I am asking you something which is little.
Go ahead.
That is.
We can hear you. Go ahead. I think he decided to run now. He wasn't sure exactly what it was, but feel free, give us that call. Want to take more of those questions, your reactions, and definitely your comments as well. 0143378722. Game on, hello. Hello, good afternoon, Asim, where are you calling from?
Oh, good afternoon, sir.
Who is this and where are you calling from?
I am Mr. Ugatifu from Kagogwa.
Yes, please. You've got Ahmed Hussein here. Your question or reaction?
I don't have any question, but I want to thank you on this.
Sorry?
I want to thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks for your program. We are here to enjoy your program.
Thank you so much. We do appreciate you for watching. Thank you so much, man. All right, 0143378722. We want to take more of those calls now. And I want to specifically focus on some of those questions you might have for the communications director from FUFA. That is Ahmed Hussein. Hello, good afternoon. Hello. Hello, we can hear you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Chief.
What's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm a single man, Geoffrey, calling from Aru.
It's good to hear from you, Geoffrey. Any questions or reactions? Geoffrey, any questions?
May I know the result of Chelsea match yesterday?
Okay, I'll try and react to that. But first things, do you support any club in Ugandan football?
Yes, I do.
Which club is that?
AC Villa.
AC Villa.
Yes.
And we've got someone from FUFA here. Do you have any questions for him?
Not really.
Okay, thank you so much. We'll get to the team news from that game yesterday. I want to say thank you so much for watching. Let's take more of those calls. 0143378722. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, good afternoon. We can hear you. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm doing very fine. What's your name?
This is David Isavie from Entebbe.
David Isavie, it's good to hear from you. Your questions or reactions for Ahmed?
I'm a journalist and I would like to thank Ahmed for the work well done.
Okay.
And your crew at Urban TV.
Thank you, David.
My question concerns the COVID-19 fund FIFA got.
Yes.
Supposed to get from FIFA.
Yes.
With all the regional clubs, inclusive clubs in our region in Entebbe, be beneficiaries. Yes.
Okay. We'll talk about the funds. Thank you so much, David. We do appreciate you, man. That is our comrade from Kao Sports. That is David Issa Avidia. Thank you so much for watching, David. We do appreciate you. And everyone that is watching the show, there are, you know, so many colleagues in the industry that do take time to watch the show. But it's 0414-337-872. We'll probably try and take one or two more calls before we get to wrap it up there. So keep the, you know, the conversation going. Hello, game on. Okay, I think we lost that one there. But also Facebook, Urban Television, Twitter, the handle is at Urban TV. Hello. Uganda. Hello, you are final caller. What's the name and where you calling from?
I'm Hassan Fredo.
Yes, please. How are you, Fredo? Sorry, lost you. But unfortunately, we've got to cut the calls there. And Hussein, let's start with the funds now, because the first batch of money that came through from FIFA, from CAF, we saw it raising a lot of dust in terms of allocation. Yesterday, the FIFA Council coming out and voting, and there's $1 million coming to each of the federations, including FUFA. There's $500,000 coming for women's football development. There's also interest-free loans coming to the different stakeholders. Some will say that is good money for the game.
Yeah, certainly not the interest-free loans.
Okay.
But the initial funds that came in, these are funds that have been coming in annually. That is the $1 million from FIFA coming in installments in January and July. Only that the $500,000 that was supposed to come in July was released a bit early because of the COVID-19 effects on the member associations. And there are forms that
So you are under no mandate to bail out the clubs with that money?
No, it's specifically for particular activities and for operational activities for the institution. But when that communication was made by FIFA, they say that they know how much club football has suffered and how much the game has been affected by the COVID-19. And they would come up with a special fund. And we are glad that yesterday at the FIFA Council, that was conducted online, they did pass that resolution. And the money will be coming through. It's about $1.5 billion. But what is coming to Uganda and even England, Brazil, is going to be $1.5 million. And the $500,000 part of that will be for women football, strictly. Then the $1 million is when, of course, the communication that FUFA sent out, the statement has made, is the emergency executive committee will meet, also direct the CEO to convene an extraordinary general assembly, which will be online, to decide on who benefits and what allocation will be going out to the beneficiaries. So it's for football in Uganda, not a particular sector. Maybe not Uganda Premier League only, maybe women football only. But FIFA were very, very strict. They said $500,000 is for women football. So of course, like I've said, the assembly and the FIFA executive committee will decide.
So for David, who was saying the lower tier sides in Entebbe, they'll be catered for in there.
Yeah, it's football that is going to benefit. It's football that's going to benefit.
Okay.
I believe so that even the clubs at the regional level, because they've contributed. Remember, they are playing under regional leagues and the regional associations are members of FIFA. Yes.
Sharon, two key things. One, the commitment by FIFA to continue helping out the federations. And secondly, the emphasis being put on women's football. It's quite immense.
Yeah. And I'm very happy that they came out with a steering committee to oversee the evaluation and the implementation of this money and how this money is going to be spent worldwide. Because, of course, you know, issues to do with the corruption and swindling money, football money has been going on. We've had the stories from all over parts of the world. And a gentleman called Oni, who happens to be the chairperson, the vice chairperson of the, is it the legal committee? Yes. Is going to spearhead. I am very, very glad, at least for the first time, that, it is not the first time the FIFA is coming out to help women football or to give funds, because we actually have FIFA grants that has been going on to all the countries, all the confederations and all the federations, associations, to categorically help women football. Unfortunately, one, it's because, one, women football does not gather a lot of revenue. You all know very well.
Actually, all FIFA tournaments.
All FIFA tournaments.
Not, apart from the FIFA Men's World Cup.
Exactly.
Don't bring revenue.
They do not get revenues at all. Totally, completely, there's nothing. And then when you come back home, this other side in Uganda, so many of these women clubs have been struggling a lot. Of course, when they say the women football, they're not going to stop at the national teams only. I expect right now Ahmed, who said he should break for us down. We have around 16 to 18 teams of women. Of course, they go beyond that because we have the ones in the region. Apparently, we have also the Region League of Women going on. Now, how are these clubs going to benefit? Because this is a time that women also need to be given back. Women also need something because, Ahmed, you know very well, you've been into management of football. You know very well that these girls are not earning any money at these clubs. They don't pay them anything.
Okay.
So is this money going to benefit the women up to the grassroots? That is what we want to know.
As we get to wrap up the conversation, because we're first running out of time, at the emphasis on women's football, we've now got to very, you know, active leagues at the very top. Post-COVID, how are we looking at football, you know, going forward? That has been a big discussion. And then finally, also the ex-internationals, because so many of them have come out, and FUFA to come and help them out because some of them are living under very poor circumstances. What do you make of all this as we wrap it up, Ahmed?
The post-COVID, of course, first of all, we are preparing for the new season, which starts on 1st of July. How we react with the government decision on when the league will football sport will be, of course, considered, especially football on our side, will also give us an opportunity. But we are hopeful that before the end of this year, there will be clearance for us to continue so that the clubs can resume and football is played in a better form. About the ex-internationals, it's unfortunate that our superstars of the yesteryears are going through the current situation they are in. We could actually talk about, say, that some of them are suffering not because that they spent their money or they misused their money. Some of them played football at the time when there wasn't money, I can tell you. And you cannot blame them for not failing to sell because there was nothing. They were popular, they got maybe little money, as opposed to what it is today. I can tell you, a player who's in the national team right now, Uganda Cranes, is earning maybe like even 100 times more than what those people were earning then. So as FUFA, we are coming up with a policy that of course will help out on the ex-internationals, on how much they will be entitled to, and that is something that's going to be passed by the executive and even the assembly, and we believe that it will help us solve. As of now, FUFA has been helping out ex-internationals on a personal basis, individual basis, and we are glad that we've been successful with that system. Only that some of them will not come out, which is good. We don't want them to come out and say, FUFA gave us this, and there are no restrictions, there are no conditions whenever passing out that bit of CSR.
Okay. Quickly, we have
the women.
Women football, actually, the 500,000, this year, FUFA is actually spending a lot of time and resources on women football, youth football as well. So women football, like you're saying, it's not money going to be shared by club officials. It's going to benefit. We don't know whether it's going to be for salaries or actually improving or making sure that the clubs not fail actually to travel for certain league matches. Because we know how much everyone has been affected, every stakeholder, even the journalists. I'm a journalist as well, but I know how much we've been affected. I know how my colleagues have been affected in the media. So you never know exactly what is going to be given out of these guys. But one thing for sure is that there's going to be $500,000 for women football in Uganda.
Thank you so much, Ahmed. Thank you so much, Sharon. And a massive thank you to everyone that has been watching the show. But the conversation does not end here. Catch up with us online, Facebook, Aban Television, Twitter. The handle is at Aban TV Uganda. We're saying, it was a fantastic sporting weekend. There's plenty of games across Spain, Italy. German Bundesliga comes to a climax this particular weekend. And Chelsea 2-1 winners last night against Manchester City. Certainly a fantastic performance. There are penalty from Willian and a strike from Christian Pulisic on the day as well. But plenty of games this weekend. And till next week, we're saying hi, so a fantastic sporting weekend. And it's a wrap.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.